What is special about this moment and our role in it as scientists is that for the first time we're actually able, because we have the tools.
The hunt for life outside our planet has been at the forefront of many astronomers' careers. While there have been technological advancements to pierce deep into the cosmos, sometimes the most compelling evidence will be found in entirely unexpected places, right in our own backyard. A team of scientists from the Massachusetts Institute of Technology recently published a paper with exciting new findings on Earth's closest neighbor, Venus. They were looking into the composition of Venus's atmosphere, which is heavily dominated by thick clouds, primarily made up of carbon dioxide, creating an extreme greenhouse effect, causing the planet to heat up to extreme temperatures. But inside these superheated clouds, astronomers found a significant amount of chemical known as phosphine inside, which can be an indicator of life. While this chemical is found in Earth's atmosphere, it hasn't been found in significant quantities on any other rocky planet because of its difficulty to create through inorganic processes. The evidence this team found is pointing directly towards some form of extraterrestrial life living high in the atmosphere of the second planet from the Sun. Phosphine, also known as PH3, can be created through inorganic processes, but it requires just the right interactions between volcanic activity, minerals, sunlight, and lightning. Computer models that have been developed to mimic the atmosphere of Venus have continued to show that this type of activity does not create anywhere close to the amount of PH3 that scientists were able to detect in the atmosphere. This means, for the time being, until scientists can learn how this phosphine is being created on Venus, alien life will remain one of the top plausible explanations for its presence. Most of us know Venus is not the most habitable planet at first glance. It is the second closest planet to the Sun and the closest planet to Earth, which meant it was the first planet that we ever sent a probe to in 1962, which gave us our first look at this hot and hostile world. Temperatures on the planet regularly reach upwards of 475 degrees Celsius. That's 900 degrees Fahrenheit, which means most life as we know it on Earth would not be able to survive. These temperatures are more than hot enough to melt lead. The high temperatures are thought to be due to a runaway greenhouse gas effect, filling the atmosphere with carbon dioxide, trapping energy more efficiently and superheating the atmosphere. Not only is Venus extremely hot, but due to the dense and heavy atmosphere, the pressure on the surface is greater than 90 times what we experience here on Earth. These sweltering and crushing conditions would make it difficult for life of any kind to begin. But then again, there are forms of life in the harshest conditions on Earth. There are several species that live their life around the boiling hot volcanic vents along the bottom of the ocean, as well as bacteria that live in the super acidic hot springs of some of Ethiopia's Danakil Depression. While there may be life on Venus, it would be a stretch to assume it will look anything like what we know from our experience on Earth. If life is behind the presence of phosphine in the atmosphere, it will most likely be some type of small anaerobic life, meaning it does not require oxygen to survive. But even life in extreme environments has its limits, and if there is life on Venus, it will most likely be isolated to very thin strips of atmosphere that are habitable while surrounded by a hostile, inhospitable world. In order to try and understand what kind of life could be here, scientists started to ask questions about how those life forms could have gotten there in the first place. This took the team to Venus's past over a billion years ago. The prevailing theory regarding Venus's past is that in its early life, it was much more like Earth-like. Both Venus and Earth were formed around the same time, around 4.5 billion years ago. In its early life, there were most likely vast oceans spread across the surface, where ancient life could have begun much like it did on our own planet. This early time on Venus would have been a much more milder place, with a habitable environment perfect for the emergence of life out of the primordial soup. Venus is also a rocky world with a composition very similar to Earth's, which adds to the likelihood that this phosphine comes from an organic source, because this chemical is very difficult to make on rocky planets. Until now, Earth was the only terrestrial planet where phosphine has been found. NASA has already approved two separate missions to the planet, set to launch in the 2030s. The Da Vinci Plus spacecraft will enter the atmosphere to examine how the atmosphere evolved, looking for any clues as to what may be hiding among the clouds. In addition, Da Vinci Plus will be taking high-resolution pictures of the Venusian surface. The second mission will send the Viratus probe close to the planet's surface in order to generate detailed maps of its geological features. Astronomers hope, by analyzing the current geology of Venus, they will be able to turn back the clock and gain a better understanding of the geological history of the planet. When these missions send back the information they acquire, scientists will have a view of Venus like never before. They will not only be able to learn about the planet's surface and climate, but this information will also give astronomers vital information into understanding a planet's habitability and give them a better idea of where to look for life elsewhere in the universe. While Venus has taken the spotlight right now, there are still several other viable options for finding life close to home. Saturn's largest moon, Titan, has been the target for many studies around the search for life. It is the only other planetary body besides Earth that has ever been found to have liquid bodies on its surface. Not only that, but astronomers have also detected many chemicals in this moon's atmosphere that could possibly sustain some form of life. Two other moons that have also been the subject of the hunt for life are another of Saturn's moons, Enceladus, and one of Jupiter's moons, Europa. Both of these moons show signs that life could currently be able to survive on their surfaces. Another planet that has also captured the minds of many astronomers hunting for life has been our next closest neighbor, Mars, who, like Venus, used to be a lot more Earth-like with oceans covering the surface. There have already been several rovers sent to Mars to try to find any evidence of life or other signs that may allow humanity to one day colonize the red planet. From all the information presently available, there is a good chance that there is, or was at some point, life on another planetary body in our solar system. And regardless of where it is found, when astronomers get definitive evidence of life, the field of astronomy will change forever. Thanks for watching. Leave us a comment down below and let us know whether you think the new probes to Venus will find concrete evidence of life or not. See you next time on Matter.